Hi student, welcome to botany class. Today we are going to start a new chapter in 11th standard, chapter number 4, reproductive morphology. So in the previous video we have discussed the vegetative morphology. So in this video we are discussing all the vegetative part of the plants. So now we are going to see the reproductive part. So what is the reproductive part of the plant? The flower is a reproductive part of the plants. So flower, it is a purpose of the reproduction. It is a mean for the reproduction. The very beginning, the plants, it will germinate to grow vegetatively. After that, the appearance of the flower on the plant, it will indicate that the plant is ready for reproduction. So the flower is nothing but it's a modified shoot system. And it's a modified floral whorls like calyx, corolla, antrisium and gynoecium. So in the reproductive morphology, we are discussed about the inflorescence, types of inflorescence, and then flower, parts of flower, and then seed. So these are the things we are going to see in this chapter. So first we are going to see the introduction. Flower have been a universal cultural object for a millennia. Several years we are used flower for cultural purposes. For many cultural events, we are using the flower. There are important aesthetic elements, very important aesthetic elements in the everyday life, and have played a highly a symbolic role. So flower, we are used for the symbolic role. And in our culture throughout the ages. So all our cultural event, the flower played important role. And also in everyday life, we have used the flowers. The extent of flower make the respect, affection, happiness and love. So flower is a symbol for the respect, affection, happiness and love. If you want to express anyone, we use the flower mean, it will be mean by the respect or the affection or the happiness or the love. Not only for nowadays, it will be followed many years ago. However, in biological point of view, the flower, it will be differ from our day-to-day life. In biological purpose of the flower is very different from the way we use and perceive. So in biological point of view, flower is helpful for the plant reproduction and its own kind. It's reproducing its own kind through the reproduction. So appearance of flower, it will be indicate the particular plant is ready for reproduction. They're ready to give a new young one. Have you seen the bucket being used during the function? We can give the bucket to anyone. So what is a bucket? Bucket is a collection of flower and the leaves. It is a bucket. The group of flower is arranged together on our preference in a bucket. But an inflorescence. Now we are into the topic inflorescence first. What is the inflorescence? It's a collection of flower in a common axis of the particular plants. Inflorescence, it's indicator a group of flower is present in a common axis. Like a bouquet. But it's not a bouquet. Bouquet, it's a collection of flower, that's all. But inflorescence, so here the many flower, it will be arise from the common axis. But an inflorescence is a group of flower is arising from the branched or unbranched axis with a definite pattern. That is very important. So definite pattern is the arrangement of the flower. So the axis is maybe branched axis or unbranched axis. That is an inflorescence. So what is the function of inflorescence? That is very important. Inflorescence means the collection of flower. It will be arise from the common axis. The axis may be branched or unbranched. So here the flowers are arranged in a definite pattern. So what is the main function of inflorescence? To display the flower for effective pollination. Which one? The inflorescence. And also it will facilitate the seed dispersal. First one is display the flower for effective pollination. Second one, it will be held for seed dispersal. The grouping of flower in one place will give a better attraction to the visiting pollinators. So pollinator, if it may be an insect or it may be a bird, like that. So various pollinators is there. Pollinators, and they maximize the energy of the plants. And it helps to maximize the energy. Have you ever noticed the inflorescence arising from a different position? If you see the plant, the group of flower is not common for all group of plants. It will vary from plants to plant. Where it is present in the plant. It may be an axial or it may be a terminal, that is apex region. So where the inflorescence are present in the plant, it may be apex or axial. So the inflorescence are present both the apex and the axial of the plant in various group of plant. Based on the position of the inflorescence, it may be classified into three major types, that is a terminal, axillary and a calciflorous. Terminal, axillary and a calciflorous. Let's see one by one. So first one is terminal inflorescence. The inflorescence grows as a part of the terminal zone. As a part of the terminal zone. So that is a terminal end. Example, raceme of Nerium oleander. Okay, the inflorescence grows as a part of the terminal zone. So that is a terminal inflorescence. Second one, axillary. The inflorescence present in the axil of the nearest vegetative leaf. So that is a vegetative leaf. So near the vegetative leaf. Near the vegetative leaf, the flower will be arranged. So that is an axillary. Example, hibiscus rosa sinensis. And calliflorus. So here the inflorescence developed directly from the woody trunk. Not at the axial, not at the terminal. It directly formed, arise from the woody trunk. Example, Theobroma coco, Chlorophyta gudensis. Observe the inflorescence of the jackfruit and the cannabal tree. So, in jackfruit and cannabal tree also it belongs to calliflorus because the inflorescence, so it's an entire inflorescence, it directly born on the woody trunk. So, based on the position, the inflorescence are classified into three types, terminal, axillary and a calliflorus. So, based on the position is over. So, next we are going to see the based on the branching pattern and the other character. Based on the branching pattern and other character. How the inflorescence classified? So, before that, the inflorescence may be classified based on the branching. So, what are the other pattern? Branching, number, arrangement of flower. Number and arrangement of flower and some specialized structure. Based on that, the inflorescence is further divided into fourth time. Further divided into fourth time. Based on the branching, number and arrangement of the flower and some other special structures. First one is indeterminate. The enforced axis, it will be grow continuously and produce a flower. So that is indeterminate. Example, racemos. So racemos is belongs to indeterminate growth. So racemos is one type of inflorescence. Determinate. So here the flower is first appear in the terminal region. It will be stage the growth of the particular inflorescence axis. So further the growth it will be occur in the lateral side. So that is determinate. Example, cymose. And mixed inflorescence. So in the mixed, the term itself has a meaning. So it is group of the inflorescence have both indeterminate and determinate. Both indeterminate and determinate. That means the inflorescence axis are the indeterminate growth. And the lateral growth, it will be like a determinate. So both indeterminate and determinate growth are present in mixed inflorescence. And special inflorescence. So, in this group is not come under either indeterminate or determinate. It's not come under either indeterminate or determinate. So, that is called special type of inflorescence. Let's see one by one. So, before that, the racemos and cymos different. So, what is the racemos? It's an indeterminate. It's a determinate. So, the main axis is unlimited growth. So here, limited growth, that is very, very important. Main axis are unlimited growth, main axis are limited growth. The flower arranged in agropetal successor. So what is the agropetal sir? Old flower present at the base of the inflorescence, young flower present at the top of the inflorescence. So here the flower arranged in a basipetal. That means, the old flower present at the top, young flower are present at the bottom. Okay. The arrangement of flower is agropetal. Old flower at the bottom, young flower at the top. Basipetal. Old flower at the top, young flower at the bottom. Opening of the flower is centripetal. You can link these two statements. Agropetal means old flower at the bottom, young flower at the top. You see, centripetal, opening of the flower. So, old flower first to open and followed by young flower. So, from bottom to top. So, that means it is a centripetal. So, here, the old flower at the top, young flower at the base or bottom. So, the opening of the flower from away from the center. So, that is centrifugal. Opening of the flower is centrifugal. Usually, the oldest flower at the base, oldest flower at the base, young flower at the terminal axis. Usually, oldest flower at the top, young flower at the bottom. So, thank you, student. So, that's all about the flower, what is inflorescence and types of inflorescence based on the position and based on the branching pattern. Okay, so next class, we are going to see that the first type, that is indeterminate or racemos type of inflorescence. Thank you, sir.